Yeah, I can report firsthand that any time that this track was included in a live set, oh man, the crowd would just go off. I got to witness that every single time from front of house, and it was absolutely awesome. Well, am I ever excited about today's session? Last week I was spinning some vinyl when I came across this deluxe edition of Skinny Puppy's Mythmaker. Man, check this track out. Yeah, that's Politikill by Skinny Puppy, and specifically the Humble Brothers mix. You know, when I heard this track coming off vinyl last week, it totally inspired me to want to go back to the original multi-track and open this session up and have a look. And so for today's session, I want to share exactly how this track came together, because it literally started with nothing more than a bass line before it morphed into the track that it became. And that only happened through an awesome process of collaboration. So let's get into it. Well, 15 years ago when we made this record, everyone was sort of working out of their satellite studios, I called it. It wasn't unusual for a song to start with cEvin in his studio as a demo, to come over to my studio and I'd help arrange and work on that track. It would go back to cEvin, potentially come back to me, go over to Mark and Ogre, back to cEvin and back to me. It wasn't unusual for a track to be bounced around that much. And Politikill is a great example of just that. Well, the original demo that cEvin sent over to me included that nasty bass line that opens up the track. As soon as I heard that riff, I'm like, that's the one. We can base this entire track on that main riff. Check it. Yeah, sort of a no-brainer. That filthy bass part from cEvin was going to become the main riff of this track. And then as I typically did, I just get busy arranging different parts around it, using all kinds of things like my own proprietary sample library, even stock sounds with effects on them, or a radio like I did right here. Check out this loop. That's just me sampling an FM receiver as I'm kind of flipping around the channels. And let's go ahead and have a listen to the original source sounds for that. I'm calling it FM3, check it. Always love the sound and grottiness that you get from FM radio, particularly that super wide aspect. I love that sample. Then I just threw it in a bunch of distortion and put some delay on it for the ultimate effect of this. That along with a stock stylus loop going through some effects, but check it. Yeah, that grotty FM loop does a great job of setting this track up, particularly as we bust into the main kind of meat and potatoes of this track. I love this sort of arpeggiated sampled guitar part, and it's an effect that I use often. So I want to share how I create this. You know, I've talked about my proprietary sample library and how extensive it is, right? Well, I've got one amazing bank of samples that I created with one of my favorite guitar players of all time, Saki Kaskas, who's credited on this song as a result of me using these samples. But we created a sample bank with Saki that is ridiculous, okay? It's like literally every single note on the guitar. And I've got all these samples laid out on a keyboard where they actually line up and they make sense with the keys. So this is a powerful tool that I created many, many years ago. And I've used it so many times in so many tracks. This is one reason that I'm always sharing why it's so important to create your own proprietary sample library. You will never have enough proprietary samples in your own collection. And one thing that can make a really unique tone. So when you start dipping into those proprietary libraries and creating parts, all I'm doing to create that is just using MIDI notes to trigger just the beginning of each one of those samples. I don't let the whole sample play out. And oh man, is this ever effective? Check it out with the visual reference of this MIDI track and you're gonna hear exactly how I went about doing this. Check it. It's like a robot guitar riff, and is it ever effective? I love it. Well, then finally, this arrangement that Kevin and I put together makes its way over to Ogre and Mark, who literally glue everything together in such a good way, and in only the way Ogre can do it. Check it. Ogre and Mark can glue tracks together like no one's business. It's not until those guys get involved that the tracks really come together for me. Right from the moment this track started to come together, I knew that down the road, I was gonna wanna do some kind of extra mix on it, some kind of heavy duty mix. And of course, I was gonna have to include my humble brother, Traz Damji. Man, am I ever glad I did, because check out what Traz's contributions add to this track. It just absolutely steps it up 10 notches. I love it. Check it. Traz is an expert at adding depth to a mix by introducing tones, things that aren't necessarily a big deal, but oh man, the addition of them makes all the difference to the tonal quality of the overall sound. You know, production-wise, I purge everything about every 6 months, so I don't remember what I did to a mix a year ago or 15 years ago. So is this ever fun to go back to the archives and pull up a session like Politikill and sort of look at the timeline and see exactly how this song came together? Now I gotta share a bit of an Easter egg on this track Politikill, because every time I hear it, it totally cracks me up. During the time that we were exchanging this track back and forth early on, like when Kevin and I were working on the arrangement, the 2006 Winter Olympics were going on, and specifically day 15 of the Olympics was February the 24th. And I went back and checked the timestamps, And this is classic because the two aggressive tape voices that I have dropped into the middle of this track is Canada winning gold at the 2006 Winter Olympics. Check this out. Day 15 was the 24th of February, the day of the men's curling finals in which Canada won its first gold medal. So these aggressive tape voices in the breakdown of Political, they're not just any tape voices. It's the Canadian men's curling team winning gold. Check it. Yeah, how suitable that a breakdown of a skinny puppy track has the Canadian men's curling team winning gold in it. And as we're coming out of this breakdown, I love this choral section that Kevin added. Yeah, the virus going through some serious distortion. Love it. I love that effect where I take the dry voice, let it happen in the middle. A bar later, I copy and paste it, pan it hard left. And a bar after that, I copy and paste it again and pan it hard right. And then ultimately just make a really tight mute on all of those tracks. There's nothing wrong with creating long vocal delays using copy and paste instead of an actual delay plugin. It'd take me forever to program that. It's just way easier to copy and paste and drag files around. Well, thank you very much for sitting in on today's session and busting open the archives and sharing a little bit of the collaborative process in making Mythmaker. That a song like Politikill, yeah, it can go from baseline to finish line through an awesome process of collaboration.
Thank you.